How's it going, everyone? It's me, Noah, here, and welcome back to another video showcasing the next mock or next episode of my Kote Clone Wars series, following the five clone troopers that are taking down the clans and the Black Sun on the planet of Ord Mantell. So yeah, in this video, I'm going to be going over the next mock right here, which you can see before me, and kind of giving the next bit of information on what is going on in this mock, as well as what they're looking for. So diving right into the story real quick, the clone troopers are currently taking out this outpost right here, which is used for communications to get messages in and out from the clans without the Republic knowing. And this outpost is quite important and quite vital for them. So the clone troopers have decided to go ahead and take out communications so that they can't communicate or talk with other clans for backup. So going on forward with the mock, or talking about the mock itself, you can see right here in the front, which I want to kind of just point out first, is this grass technique that I used right here. It's using the vine piece right here, or not really a vine, but it's more of a stalk piece right here, which is in olive green. And I thought the idea to use that right here in the front would look quite cool. I've had a couple of ideas of using this piece, not just in this color, but in other colors. So it might come up in another mock in the future. But I thought this technique really worked out really well. And also in combination with these light bluish gray rocks that are right here. Also a couple of these puddles right here, which are made up of 1x2 tiles in trans black, and they're covered with a couple of 1x1 plates in olive green. So you got one right there, as well as one right here. And those are also surrounded by a couple of flowers or mushrooms to kind of give it a couple of bits of plants that are growing right around that area. And then right here to the main battle area or scene, you can see the clone troopers right here. Or the main force of them are on this side. They've already taken out one of the pirates or clan members right here, and the others are right about to turn this corner right here and get out into the open to kill out these, or to remove these other members of the clan. Down here on the ground, you can see another member of the group that has already been shot dead, as well as a couple canisters and things that are used for small details with a small wrench on one of them. And then using the inside parts of the tires from a couple of Speed Champion sets, I made this yellow barrel right here, which is connected with a bar piece as well as a stud on top to kind of give it a closed look right there. And I thought this was pretty cool to add right here, as well as on the top of this rooftop. On this side of the mock right here, you can see one of the members of the clone squad, which is of course made up of five members, about to turn out around this corner and take out the clan member right here who's about to shoot at him. And then behind that figure is, you can see a couple of little details here in the corner, which is of course this running faucet or water right here, which is using a new superhero piece, kind of like a power-up piece, and instead I'm using it for water that's rushing into a small black pot, as well as some other buckets, a small pipe piece, and then if we come around here, you can see a flower pot with a flower in it. Moving on to the building, I really wanted to give it this cool, more Middle Eastern effect, and I think I achieved it quite well. It's more of a Star Wars vibed version, as a lot of those buildings are of course more tan, dark tan, and I decided to go with white because I thought that would look a little bit cooler. Has a couple of different layers of colors, of course starting with dark tan on the ground, light bluish gray, the white, and then in combination with the sand blue, I think that gives it a cool line or effect that's of course towards the top of each parts of the building. And then on this rooftop, of course, there's some fuel canisters or barrels, as well as a sniper. A couple other things I would like to point out are these windows right here, where I used some older wind screen panels right here in blue. And those are just held together or held in there by friction, as well as right here, where there are a couple of chairs used for this small roof or canopy part that's in between the two buildings. And those are put upside down, and I thought that was a pretty good use right there, and it kind of cuts it off a little bit with the white, and of course works with the browned brown frames of the windows. And then right here is a small panel right here that is connected to some kind of electrical outlet. This could also be the communication tool that they are using, and that pipe piece or that rod goes around the building. Going up the building right here, you can see the top, which is just decorated with a couple of cool 2x2 round pieces, these dome slash pieces right there, as well as these new fence pieces that were seen on the pick-a-brick wall at the Lego store. So yeah, guys, I think that basically does it for this mock. I hope you guys did enjoy this episode or this build for the second episode. If you guys did, then don't forget to, of course, leave a like, comment down below your favorite part about this. If you guys want to see the other parts that will either be released after this or have already been released before this, then click the playlist down in the description below. And yeah, I think that basically does it for this video. If you guys did enjoy, leave a like and comment down below, and I'll see you in the next episode.